What's up, guys? Matacaster here, and today we are back in City State, continuing to build our dictatorship in an attempt to get the people to overthrow the government, which can happen in this game. We're trying to build a dictatorship. Yeah, our city is, or our country, this Taco Fart, now has a population of 4,135. And before we get into this, guys, I wanted to mention that I am getting back into subscriber giveaways. So if you want to subscribe and you want to win something, then by all means. I haven't really figured out exactly what it is last time. It was a Steam gift card. But if I want to do something different, I want to, you know, figure something out. But we'll get there when we get there. But the plans are in the works, so if you want in on that, then please subscribe, and then there'll be more details later. But like I said last time, yeah, we did the Steam gift card. It was kind of weird how it worked out. You have to like friend the person on Steam, and then you have to wait like a certain amount of days before you can give it away, and then, you know, it was kind of a thing. But I'm gonna figure something else out, and if you have any suggestions, please leave them down below. I would definitely appreciate it. All right, back to City State and our dictatorship. We have our little country here, more or less. That's pretty much how they're seen. And then we, you know, you run all the politics and everything. If you didn't catch the first video, it might be worth checking that out. Just uploaded it not too long ago. But it goes over how the government works and everything in this game. And we've got our little bunker over here that we're running everything out of pretty much. And this is our little, this is the residence, and this is some of the industrial area. And then we've got mines. We've got gold mines that they're currently mining right now. They're state-owned gold mines, so the money goes directly towards us. And we are currently in the green down here, if you look at the cash inflow. So we're doing all right. We're not making a ton of money, but the more population we get, the more we can tax. And looks like we've got something here. Address an issue. We've got an issue. Family allowances. What benefits should families get from the government? No allowance. Minimal allowance to low-income, large, and single-parent families. Allowance to all low-income families weighted by the number of children. Extended allowances to all families depending on the number of children in the household. There's certain... And if you're not familiar with City State, you can look down here and see the estimated approval rating. Our approval rating right now is 16%, which, believe it or not, isn't bad. The previous video, we were just hovering around 7%. So it is going up, surprisingly. Estimated revenue from this is zero. Minimal allowance to low-income and large single-parent families. Estimated revenue, see, we'd be losing quite a bit of money there, but it would get us net us 1 point of approval point. And then allowance to all low-income families weighted by number of children. Minus 41, plus 4 points on the approval. But here's the expensive one. Extended allowances to all families depending on the number of children in the household. Minus 82, and then plus 6 on the approval rating. Well, here's the thing. We're not going for approval. We're going to try to see if the people will overtake. So we're going no allowance. And lower class growth went up over that. And it really didn't affect our approval rating very much. Oh, there it went. It went from 6. Cut it in half. All right. Well, that being said, let's clear out some of this area here. I want to check and go over here to mine. Make sure I'm not taking out any gold, high prospected gold area. Okay, there's an 81% chance there. Let's go ahead and check it. Start underground survey. We will drill it, and they did find gold. We'll do a state-owned mine, and then we can pretty much clear the rest of that out by the way it looked. Yeah, there's really not much over here, nothing back here. So we might want to run a road over to here. Yeah, we should probably do that, and then that'll give us plenty of room to expand back in through here. All right, so let's get going on that. We should probably bulldoze and clear this area so we can run our road. And we've got another issue that just popped up. I'll get to that in a moment. It's too bad that this is kind of expensive to clear. I think it's like $50 per. We'll just clear the majority of this for a road. We should probably clear it. Because From a road, you can go three back. So we want to put the road in a strategic area to get the most housing in that area. And see, it's nice because it automatically attaches the road, much like any of those other city builders, but this is especially nice. Okay, so we go down here and we can go three back. So one, two, three. So we'll go here. Again, let's double check. One, two, three. And then one there and then down. Now, another thing to keep in mind is down here in the unemployment, we are at 30.4%. So we should probably add more industry. Let's see, industrial lots. And yeah, there we go. Industrial lots. Put one there, just to try to help with the unemployment rate. It's something you have to keep in mind here. We'll put one there. And let's just put another one there. Then we'll do the rest. Housing. Low density housing. There, there. Just kind of fill this area in. Because it'd be nice to have the tax income from the housing. Okay, unemployment rate is going down. Go ahead and bulldoze this area back here and get some more industrial there. Beautiful. And I don't really want to fill this in yet because I might want to make a road out to here. We should probably check this, check for iron here. Oh, we got an achievement unlocked. Third world country. How about that? Iron prospect is 79%. Let's go ahead and... That's probably not worth it. No resource found. That's what I thought. Okay, stop survey and we'll clear that out. At least we know. So what we'll do is we'll bulldoze these areas here and then just put maybe more housing there. Because I think I want to open more mines. And we've got two issues to address. Healthcare system. To what extent should the government fund the healthcare system? No involvement of the government. Healthcare is handled by private companies only. Public hospitals should provide affordable care to the families in need. Extended coverage with annual fee based on family incomes and public access to families in need. Entirely public funded. Compulsory contribution. All citizens receive the same level of cover. Imagine how expensive that one is. Yeah, look at that. That's pricey. Let's look at our options here. Yeah, who knew healthcare was expensive, right? That could get out of control. No involvement in the government. Healthcare is handled by private companies only. Let's go ahead and do it. Again, we're not trying to be nice. We're trying to get everybody to overthrow us. How does the lower class like that? I'm surprised. Middle class didn't, but we don't really... If you look down here at the population, the middle class and high class, we don't really have any of those, really. Our trade capacity is insufficient. Industries and farms will leave the county if we don't build new infrastructures. Okay. Well, what infrastructures do we need? If you look up here, our approval rating is at 2%, but our stability is really good. 99% stability. Our unemployment just jumped up to 30.3%. We should probably open more mines to try to employ the people. That way they at least have jobs. There's 90%, 89, 91. Let's go ahead and survey that. Drill. They found gold. State-owned mine. Let's go ahead and build a road out here so they can get to the mine. Oh, missed one. Right there. Okay, we're good to build a road. We've got another issue. Labor law. Should our labor law regulate more extensively work contracts and relationships between employees and employers? Corporations are free to elaborate their own contracts as long as they are signed by the two parties and duly fulfilled. All work contracts must follow a maximum work hours and grant holidays, pregnancy, and illness leaves. All of the above plus minimum wage, termination rights, and retirement plans are law. Our labor law should prohibit termination and grant extensive rights to all employees with mandatory trade unions. We don't want that if we're a dictatorship. This one doesn't really affect us financially, and it gives us a good boost in approval rating. If you look at the first one here, it's a -4. Let's go ahead and do that. All work contracts must follow maximum work hours and grant holidays, pregnancy, and illness leaves. I feel good about that anyways. There's ones I just can't do, like the animal one from the last episode. Like, you know, gotta protect the animals. Let's do some commercialized zones here. We'll do medium. We'll just do those right here. Maybe that'll help with our unemployment a little bit. And then we'll do some more housing. We'll do some low density housing. Well, medium. Let's go medium, just in this little area here. And it looks like we have an abandoned... No, is it? Hard to say. Let's get the information here. Abandoned lot, so we want to take care of that. Get rid of that. Put in medium density housing. So this right here, this is the high density housing, as you can tell. That's pretty dense. It clutters up the map pretty good. But the more people you have living here, the more taxes you get. We've got a lot of abandoned industry over here. Probably not helping our issue with unemployment. More issues to address. Public utilities. Should electricity, water, waste disposal be handled by the municipalities? All utilities should be privatized and open to free concurrence. Allow public-private partnerships to manage service utilities. These utilities should only be handled by local municipalities and public companies. Every utility is public institution. Employees benefit from special pension program and security of employment. Well, let's look at the... Yeah, that's expensive, of course. And that one's not real cheap. Allow public-private partnerships to manage service utilities. Not too bad, really, as far as what people think of that. Got another issue. Should guns be legal? Oh, here we go. Guns should be entirely legal and sold with normal tax rates. Possession is legal and taxed, but carrying of the firearm is forbidden. Possession permission only for hunting license and policemen. Guns are illegal. Police officers can only carry firearms under special situations. Well, if you want to be a dictatorship and control your people, we'll go with that. This, guys, I promise, I have no horse in the race on any of this stuff. I'm just messing around, having fun, trying to see if I can get people to overthrow the government. Or my government, you know. Not the government, you know what I mean, right? We're just trying worst case scenario here to see what could happen. Start an underground survey on this area to see if they found iron. State owned mine. I want to try to get people employed. Try to get that employment rate to kind of level out to a decent amount. So mines are probably going to be the best way to go about it. Let's go ahead and start a survey here. They found a state owned mine. There we go. We're getting people employed now. And we're gaining resources, which is really nice. Got another new issue. Legal worked hours. How many working hours should the citizens be allowed to do? The government should not put any limitation on the number of hours allowed to be worked. The number of hours allowed to be worked is limited to 50 per week, and then consequently 40 to 30. Let's see what the people think. Minus 10 points. It's not really costing us anything. And it gives us a chance to gain a little bit in approval rating. 30 hours per week, that's really not going to work. That's work. I'm thinking, let's just upset everybody. The lower class liked that. That is really, really puzzling to me. It seems that this industry, I keep putting industry back there and it keeps going abandoned. And here too. I think what I want to do is just go ahead and put housing there. That seems to be doing better, and we make, you know, good tax money off the housing anyways. Went with medium density housing there. Yeah, and this industry, I just put that in. They just built on it and it just went abandoned, so. industry is not the big thing here. I think it's mostly centered around the mines as far as employment. And I did this commercial zones, and nothing's really popping up for those. And did this commercial zone a long time ago. Nothing there. It appears we can do a state-owned steelworks production facility or a weapons plant. State-owned. I'm kind of intrigued by the weapons plant. I say we build one. Put it right there. Clouds kind of getting in the way. Wonder if I can turn the clouds off. Oh, we got another issue. Gambling and casinos. To what extent should we allow gambling? All gambling businesses allowed. No license required. Limited number of casino licenses granted on regular inspections. Casinos are banned. Sports betting tolerated. All type of gambling banned. Well, you'd think you'd want gambling because you can make a good amount of money. What is the, estimated revenue 41, estimated revenue 82 on all gambling businesses allowed. And then, of course, we won't make anything here and we lose approval. Let them go nuts. All gambling businesses allowed, no license required. All right. We're making good money down here, 640, but our unemployment rate's at 35.4 despite all these mines that I've opened up. I wonder about opening up the steelworks and see if that helps at all with any kind of unemployment. Yeah, let's turn those clouds off. Oh yeah, there they are. They're dissipating. Oh, that's awesome. That's really cool that they don't just, boom, disappear. They dissipate, as clouds do. Another issue, taxicab regulation. Should we control the quantity and quality of taxicabs in our state? No regulation. Anyone can be a taxi driver with a regular business permit. Standard taxicab license required to operate. Limited number of licenses to be allocated on the basis of an auctioning system. All taxicabs are operated and controlled by a state-owned company. That sounds good. No real change, and it actually was going to give us money. So it appears the industry is not serving us well. So we'll just allocate all this to housing. Because it's just not. I've tried to put it there. Apparently people aren't wanting to work there. Probably because the really awful things I laid out. The policies. That's probably do it. So that's something to think about. It's cool that it's included in the game. Because one thing you do can totally affect another thing you do, and you didn't even think it would, but it does. And that's really neat. I think that's one of the cool, challenging parts of this game. But you can see, as they're building those houses, that unemployment rate is just going up and up. Even though I've got so many mines in operation, it just keeps going up. Okay, I'm looking at our budget. We're starting to get some high-class people, or higher income, moving in. So I want to get them kind of an incentive to come. So I'm going to tax them at 5%. Middle class currently, I'll just leave it at 2. We're not dealing with them. That's they're not really an issue right now. We only have a little bit of revenue coming in from there and not very many people, but lower income definitely do. So we want that influx of cash, 830 right now. We're doing well. We haven't taken out any loans or bonds or anything like that. And so that keeps our credit rating at a triple A. The quote-unquote state or country or whatever this is the stability is fluctuating. It's not as strong as it once was. The approval rating is kind of hovering around 15%. But, not too bad. Pretty stable. I'm just waiting for it to all go wrong. New issue. Foreign investments. Should the government limit foreign investments? Our borders are fully open to foreign capital and foreign ownership. Limit foreign ownership of companies. Allow investments. Ban foreign ownership of land and companies. Allow investments. Ban foreign ownership of land and companies and all foreign investments. That's what we're going with. We want to be like a dark state. Taco fart. Socialist democracy. Population 10,145. We're growing, folks. We're growing. And look at that, we're getting some skyscrapers or small little skyscrapers, mini skyscrapers popping up. That's pretty cool. New issue, Public transportation. Should public money serve to improve the transport systems? Railroads, airports, urban transports, and highways should all be privatized. Public-private partnerships should be allowed to all transport systems. Municipalities are encouraged to provide public transports, and only airports can be operated by private companies. We must provide affordable and extensive public transport systems to all citizens. Private funds are not accepted. Let's just see what the... Oh, that's expensive for us. That one's not too bad. We make a profit there and lose a little bit. And then we make, of course, a big profit there and lose quite a bit of approval rating. Should they be privatized? Public-private partnerships should be allowed to all transport systems. That sounds good to me. We are now a liberal democracy. How do we get to dictatorship? I wonder if that's even a thing in here. I think we're going to open up more farmland. I don't think we had... We had some at one point, but it appears we do not anymore. So I'm going to clear this area out and make it farmland. That'll give us some resources to trade with and such. That'll come in handy. Farmland. It's really not that expensive for us to build farmland here. And remember, we can go three back from any road. That's exactly what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to leave this open because I know eventually we're probably going to want to extend out here. Might as well take care of that now, just so I remind myself not to build anything there. We seem to be making a killing on our cash flow, but our unemployment rate is 62.1%, which is probably leading to a very bad approval rating. I'm trying to figure out how to rectify that. If you guys have any tips, if you play this game, let me know, because I've opened up so many mines. You'd think that would... Let's highlight over one. Occupants, 42. Employees, 188. Then we got 193 there. Yeah, it's not like it employs a whole lot of people, but anytime I try to open up industry, it gets abandoned. I wonder if I can give tax incentives to, let's see, education. Well, we don't have any of that set up yet. I wonder if there's a way to entice businesses to come in. I mean, I got people willing to work, got a high unemployment rate, be able to find workers easily. Got a new issue. Detention and rehabilitation. How should criminals be dealt with in the justice system? Criminals are required to perform penal labor for their time of detention in private jails. Prisoners are all assigned to private jails. Prisoners are assigned to public jails. Prisoners are assigned to public jails, and all of them are interrogated to or integrate. Sorry, guys. All of them are integrated to rehabilitation program. That one, of course, is going to be expensive. But we're actually crushing it right now. Look at this cash flow. So we can afford to... But again, I want to try to upset the people. As messed up as that sounds. I just want to see the riot. Because that's a thing in city-state, is riots. We'll do the private jails one. And the penal labor. We are now a liberal oligarchy. So I think that means we're starting to teeter towards that possible dictatorship. People are protesting against income inequalities. Is it happening? It's happening. Oh, it's happening. Are they going to start setting things on fire? They're throwing things. Molotov cocktails. Throwing something on fire. Did we get what we want? Are we getting overthrown? Okay, apparently the riot's over. Didn't look like they really damaged much of anything. As you can see, it's growing quite quickly. Let's try another industrial thing over here and see what happens. I put a couple over here, and there's a couple buildings, and they're building another one right now. But the unemployment is still at 62.9%. We are definitely growing. We're approaching 15,000 in the population, which will unlock once you go over here to like special buildings. It's going to unlock certain things. Once we get to 50K, we'll find out what this is. Oak City, it says. It's a base of some sort. Oh, we've got an issue. Copyrights and patents. Should copyrights and patents be enforced by the government? Do not grant any intellectual property ownership. Well, obviously, that's it right there. I'm trying to find ways to make my approval rating tank. And by doing so, hopefully that will, you know, get our stability way down and then things just go chaotic. The farm came out nice. Eventually, I want to get a road down to over here because there's oil down here. And if you go to special buildings here, requires oil wells. This is a refinery. It'll probably make us pretty good money. And then, yeah, there's other things that unlock that are going to be fun to see how those affect things. We are becoming a very wealthy country. That's for sure. Just wish we could figure out a way to get that unemployment down. Or maybe keep it up, and that'll unsettle things and there'll be more riots. But guys, I think that's where I'm going to leave this one. We're going to continue to grow this and let it grow and grow. And then maybe that's what I'll do, is try to keep it stable for a good long time till we get really big and big buildings and everything, and then just try to dip the thing into chaos, start taxing at a ridiculous rate, and see what happens. Maybe we'll do that in the next one. But guys, thank you so much, as always. And if you made it this far, please leave a thumbs up. I definitely appreciate it. It's a small channel, and it helps it grow. And I'd sure appreciate it if you subscribed. Guys, thanks so much, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.